Good morning to
Okay.
all. It gives me immense pleasure to presenting the welcome speech. On behalf of IST staff chapter, I welcome our Honorable Secretary Sir, respected Principal Madam, our resource person Dr. Rita Bhattacharji, beloved Vice Principal Sir, HODs of various departments and faculty members. Also my special welcome to our special guest Sundara Bharathi Sir and Balachandran Sir. Before introducing our resource person, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to our resource person, Madam, for accepting this invitation to present this webinar on challenges in life on faculty perspective under IST staff chapter. I would like to give short introduction about our resource person. Dr. Rita Bhattacharji is a counseling psychologist by profession and has successfully completed her doctorate degree from Avinasi Lingam University, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. She is also qualified with an MBA degree specialized in human resource management. She has specially qualified with psychological counseling and helped the students in the awareness of career level also. She has begun her career in an international organization, Ooty, Tamil Nadu, followed by a lecturer in a medical college to teach behavioral science for the medical students as well as counseling students whenever required. Also, she has an experience in counseling to engineering students, arts and science students, dental, as well as school students. She has started a counseling service at National Institute of Science and Technology, Berhampur, Odisha, in her tenure period of 2014 to 18. Besides counseling, she has taught psychology and human resource management to students in her career. At present, 2018 to till date, she is leading a team of counselors working in collaboration with them to deal with the students of present generation at VIT Vellore. She has published 7 papers in national, international journals and presented almost 20 papers in national and international conferences. A guest speaker, resource person in various places, motivational and challenging talks in various places like as follows. She delivered the talks on the topics of safeguarding mental health of teachers, basics of counseling, mental health therapeutic perspective, counseling skills for teachers, stress management through online STTP series 1, 2, 3 on guidance and counseling at St. Joseph College of Engineering and Technology, Palai, Kerala, during February 2021, December 2020, and also October 2020. Case study presentation on Avinasi Lingam University for Women, 23rd September 2019. She delivered talk on facing challenges in life for the students and faculty at St. Agnes College, Mangalore, February 2019. Also, she delivered talk on role of stress audit and stress counseling in academic excellence, pre-conference workshop, Hyderabad, 10th November 2018. Also, she delivered talk on student counseling service for faculty at HSER Berhampur, Odisha on 26th July 2017. Also, she delivered talk on lifestyle for wellness for officers grade at Prasar Bharati, Bhuvaneshwar, Odisha on 2nd March 2017. Counseling is her passion in life and she would like to create an awareness in each one their purpose in life, which should stand as one of the priority in everyone to lead a happy and peaceful life. She believed that everyone has potential in them and wonders can happen with proper care and guidance with an enthusiasm to work for it. Madam, really we are very happy about your presence as a resource person Our wholehearted welcome to you, ma'am. We hope that the session will give very good content to us. Once again, I welcome all of you on behalf of IST Staff Chapter. Thank you. Now I hand over the session to our resource person.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's a great opportunity for me to speak on the topic, which is the demand of the year. Yes, pandemic. It's a challenge not only for us, not only for India. It is a challenge for the whole world, where each and every person are challenging their own life, their health, whether it is physical or mental. Honorable and respected dignitaries present here, my dear friend Nanajar Madam, who has really been taking the struggle to call me up, and we have been also saying that this day or that day, and at last the day has come where I'm speaking about the topic here. Challenges are very, very important, and we should take the challenges. Until and unless we take the challenges in life, we cannot face the world. We cannot enjoy our life. And you know why I have taken challenges in life on faculty perspective? Because when I see so many, many papers and surveys taking place with the challenges on students, challenges taken by children, but very few topics are on the faculty. Don't you think the faculty plays a major role in the society now? They are. One of the greatest challenges that has been taken place with the faculty, because first of all, when we face the challenge, feel that it is not up to me. But when we come on and start working on it, we feel that why not the next moment and all. So here, sometimes we are feeling worthless, thinking about God, that why am I being given like that? But why can't we think that I am the person who can take up this challenge, that is what God has given to me? So sometimes we feel that why no one is there to help me out? But you know, until and unless you do it, there will be no one to work it out. Students are calling me for many, many cases, and what I say is a challenge again. So until and unless you take a challenge in life, we cannot walk for the next step. Well, I will be starting with my presentation now. I'll be showing the PPT. There we are. Challenges in life. And Madam has given a very detailed description of mine. And yes, what I feel is, I have quoted some of the things that, like Dr. Lewis has said, life is a journey and the challenges you face are obstacles that you have to overcome. They are what allow you to expand yourself, become more inclusive and compassionate. When you take a challenge, when you face a life obstacle, the next picture shows that there is a person, you know, extending help when you cannot do it. So there will be always a person to help you out. Just go forward. Search the challenge of your life, how you're going to take care. And yes, let the session be more interactive. I will be speaking from my experience, no doubt. But if it is more interactive, we will be helping to help ourselves. Usually the psychologists, they don't give advice or suggestions or anything, but make an atmosphere where we help each other. So now we can see a butterfly. This is a life lesson. I felt that such a challenge is being taken by the butterfly here. Now, when one step, the next step, the next step, it goes on and on and on, and later it tries to fly. But if you think that if you cut open on the second or third stage itself, will it be able to fly? There's a question again. I will be coming with a short video which will explain if the butterfly takes a challenge to fly, it will. But if you try to help the butterfly in midwin, in middle or second or third stage, I don't think so it will be able to fly. Come on, let us see a small video here where you can see what happens when the challenge is not taken, right? How is it? So that is what challenging is. Never say no to challenges. Am I audible?
Yes, madam.
Yes, madam.
That's a great challenge for me now. So I cannot see anyone, but everyone can see me. So that's what I felt, that challenges in life to be taken. If it is shortened and if anyone comes and helps us out, that will be the same like the story of the butterfly who cannot fly but will be depending on someone to help the butterfly or us to suggest or think of some situation to be taken care. Why do we have to depend on someone when we can do it by ourselves? So this is a small quote which I felt that yes, I could share with you all. Challenges in life are different for every individual and is unique the way he or she deals with it. My challenge is different as compared to anyone's challenges over there. Few are able to deal with, leading to higher achievement of happiness in life, and few are not able to deal, which leads to end their life. This is what the difference is. The step has to be taken by each one in their unique lifestyle. As in psychology, we have learned one thing like fight or flight. Just go for it or leave the place. So it's up to the choice of the person again. What are you going to do over there? Now, challenges are part of life and something we all encounter at one point or another during our lifetime. I will be showing how each one has faced a challenge right from the childhood. You know, even during pandemic, a pregnant mother finds a challenge to deliver her baby. You know, one day we might feel like we have it all figured out, and the other moment we feel directionless. We don't know what to do. Everyone goes through these feelings and has to face their own set of challenges. Challenges are what make life interesting, and overcoming them is what makes life meaningful. So taking the overview of the teacher, there are challenges where the teachers, the faculty are facing nowadays. Now, before COVID, it's a different challenge was, and now it's a different challenge again. And after that also, it's a big challenge which is being seen. Is everything okay? Because I could find some sound which is coming out. Is everything okay with you all?
Okay, ma'am.
It's okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Now, before COVID, teachers were teaching face-to-face. Now, come on, we don't know who is listening to us and who is not. Okay, online engagement of students is a very big challenge for the teachers now. Preparing lesson plan or session plan, they used to go for the classes. But now they have to learn technological skill, which may not be a part of their career. They have to do it. Reporting to management was a skill before, but now they have to report through email or phone. They have to do it. Documentations academically was kept, but now they have to record a session, like as we go for webinars or as we take classes for our students. We have to record and keep it for them so that they can also view it. The examinations, it's tough for both students and teachers, because when you sit for an examination invigilator, you don't know the student is there or not. And the student may say that I do not have the network to write the exam now. So can you just conduct for me a little bit later? So it cannot be done. So managing the technology for online test is a great challenge, which I could feel. I could get so many phone calls. Like, I could not upload my answer, ma'am. The last answer was kept aside because of no network connection. So these are a few things I felt. Now, some common problems which usually everyone has are overworkload. It's the same thing every time. Now it has been becoming over and over. But more job insecurity are seen nowadays. Now, when we as teachers, we teach, it's not only the students, those.
It's frozen. Oh.
To see us and listen to a challenge again. The stress is everywhere there. The student problems in pre-COVID as well as now, it has increased. Co-teachers' ego problem, what we feel is in a same department. Why? What is the problem? What is the stress behind that? The management issues are always there. So in this, in post-COVID, there has been issues where the students are not coming to the schools or colleges or universities. They have been raising such things like, why do I have to pay the full fees, which directly goes to the teachers' financial issues. The anxiety, the fear, which are always there with the person, has increased now. The hopelessness and helplessness, as well as the lack of skills and interest. There's a few of the things which I felt that I should jot it out in order to say that we have to overcome all this. But how do we have to overcome is a session now which we are going to look for. Now, challenges in life, it's a work-life balance, it's always a challenge, whether you consider it is a pre-COVID or a post-COVID. As a faculty, I would like to ask you all, so as an audience there, can you just point out some of the challenges which you are facing nowadays? So it becomes an interactive again. So I'm not going to speak much about it because each and every one knows about our challenges. You can jot it down in the chat list, or you can unmute yourself with the permission of Professor Nanajaya, if they can speak about the challenges that they are facing. Yes?
May I?
Yes, please.
See, this is actually a problem where our workspace is eating into our home space.
Yes.
And that is disruptive to both.
Mm-hmm.
Both are equally affected, right? We're doing it at home, unless you have an exclusive space where you will not be disturbed by people at home.
Okay.
Making a presentation for a class is going to be tough. And all said and done, the usual chalk walk and talk and the personal interaction, face-to-face interaction is going to be missing, even though we do see them on screen, the students on screen. I think these two are the major issues that we have found.
Okay. Okay. May I know your good name, sir?
I'm Sundar Bharti.
Oh, yourself. Okay, sir. I could not see you. So. So, yes, sir, that's a great challenge that you have pointed out. Like, we cannot see face to face, the same as well as in counseling, what I would say. Like, as long as if we faced the students in front of us, it becomes a great challenge.
Yes.
Like, usually what we do is we come back to the institution we teach, and just we forget to have a family life in our home, in our house. But now the workspace and family space are all together in.
It's getting frozen.
One place. Ah. That is a, how, anyhow, we are facing the challenges. Can I request, like, how do we face the challenges? We are, if any tips can be given by anyone.
From me, you mean, man?
Oh, you can? Yes, sir.
No. I think we need to find an exclusive space, and we need to get the understanding of the people at home to provide us the kind of privacy that is required to conduct a class for the students.
Yes, that's the time thing. Yes. Like, we have particular time for the classes. So if that particular time can be managed only for the class, the rest of the time we can give it for the family.
Precisely.
So yes, we are been doing it.
Yes,
oh, thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Rita, this is Balachandran. I think as a counselor, because most of the faculty members, they have to act as the counselor in transforming the student to keep themselves engaged productively online. You need to understand and evaluate the mindset of the student. What is the mindset they have at the beginning of the day? I think that's the most important thing. Before you motivate the student to come online for online learning, you need to understand and see that the mindsets are different.
You're very much right, sir.
Adaptability of the mindset. That is very important.
Yes. Yeah, that is what the mindset of the student you are speaking, sir. That is very much right. But here we would like to give more focus to the faculty because they are left behind somewhere. So, how are the faculty feeling? That's what the more important thing which I would like to focus. Yes, as Professor Balachandran sir and Professor Sundar Bharti sir, they have pointed out very nicely that yes, the mindset, the adaptability, the space concern has to be taken care anyway. So can I have some of the faculty from King's College also? If there is a chat, they can come out with, or they can unmute themselves also and speak out. What are the challenges do you face as a faculty?
Madam, one faculty posted her question in chat box, madam.
Okay.
Madam?
Can I read, madam?
Please, can you please read out? Yeah, I cannot.
Student engagement and participation tracking through online mode.
Okay, okay. That is the challenge the faculty has been facing in. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now as a faculty, which I have personally also experienced, like we may not be having the same type of audience or the students that we used to have in our classes. In class, speech more, interact less. But in online mode, we have to interact more and teach less. So the teaching should be going on as usual. But in between, in order to see their adaptability as such to the online mode, whether they are there or not, what is their mindset, whether they are focusing or not, and what do they learn from it, you know? When you're going to talk about any topic, if you can give the update of it to make it more interesting, to make it more simple for the student to understand, it will be more interactive in the session here. So the interaction should be more, and you should talk about, you know, calling the student's name. That is what we usually do in our classes, even in online mode. If you want to an answer from any of the student, because you would be knowing the students better, so you can just talk about the about, you can ask any question or hello, how are you, mentioning the student's name and all. How are others, how are the things going on? So somehow, somewhere, some interaction beyond the teaching has to take place to make them attention seeking in the class. Usually people, students will not be so much attention oriented since it is online, since no one can see them. They can somehow just switch it on and give the attendance and, you know, go away from anywhere else. So they may be eating there, they may be sleeping there, we do not know. So just an interaction in between the classes, you can call up the names so that each one will be alert, thinking that my name will be called up anytime, so I have to talk to the person there. So this is what an interaction, talking to them in a general term, motivating them in terms, what are they going to do as an engineering college. Yesterday I was interacting with one of the student who said that I am losing my concentration. Even I am sitting in front of the online mode class, I don't think so, I am listening to that. So in that, I just went apart from the academics and I told that you are a third year student. Where would you like to see yourself after 2 years of your lifetime? So there are some changes the way we talk, where people will be eagerly waiting to talk to us. So this is what we can do, ma'am. Any other questions?
One more thing, I think there should be a lot of mood enhancing moments in the early in the morning, like listening to mood enhancing song. That will make the mindset of the students to stay focused on online mode, and they have to reimagine their online learning. What are the criteria for reimagining the learning agenda?
Okay, it's a big challenge again. So I was into it. So any other, it's just an interactive session again. Any other challenges which our faculty faces? Is there anywhere where they have given in the chat list?
Appropriate use of technology, yes, as ma'am, we are facing right now.
Yeah, the technology is very, very important now. Main issue is handling the kids at home and the elders while doing the work. It's very, very much pointed out. Very nice. That is what we feel, that the kids, it depends upon the age of the kids. So in one of my webinar I was just talking to, where I felt that a parent is asking about a six-year-old kid, where they felt that the kid is very naughty. Obviously the kid will be naughty, and when they're not allowed to go out anywhere, the naughtiness will be seen at home. So what I said is, you know, when the kid is naughty, just go and give him or her a big hug, you know.
Hello, ma'am. Okay. Yeah, I'm Tyagaraja.
Oh, sir. Yes, sir.
How are you? See, the biggest challenge for the faculty is that they have to adjust to the camera first. See, whatever the are going to make it, it should see that appear for the students that they are watching you.
Yes. So
that's
yes.
The camera, how exactly we have to tune to the camera, and how we speak in terms of the language. And it should be the language which we are going to use. It must be much more, much slow paced when compared to the classroom teaching. As now, yes, what you are talking now, it is very clear. Mm-hmm. There's a pause between each words, and then we have to get proceeded. So altogether, that first thing is the faculty have to be trained how exactly we are to face to the camera, and it must be more appealing. Whereas the student, as you said, that he may sleep or he may be awake or he may be sitting, anything he may do. But as for the faculty, have to be neatly dressed and then see that they are appealing to each other. The second point I would like to make it is that it is the biggest challenge for the faculty is how exactly to prepare the content and deliver it in the shortest possible time in the e-learning process. So it is not the same kind of a content which they we have prepared for the classroom or the notes, which is will not may not work out well in the case of online teaching. Specifically, if you are trying to handle some kind of a problems, which in the problematic subjects, the teachers have to be doubly careful in making them to understand. It is not simply writing the formulas, substitute the values, and then this is the answer. And they have to much more clearly able to explain each step in the case of the problematic subject.
Excellent, sir.
Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you so much. You have made my work easier. And so all the talented people are over here anyway, and more interactivity is being done. I think so. There's a question on feel difficult to adapt to online mode teaching. That is where Dr. Tyagaraja sir has explained that this is how you can, you know, make your online mode teaching easier. You know, sometimes we can also say that I cannot see you. Okay, kindly turn on the video, I can see you. So these are some different simple talks where we can talk about it. And yes, student engagement and participation tracking through online mode was pointed out by Avirami ma'am there. And tracking can be more with the interaction. Like here, I am not here to give any lecture, but it is an interactive mode where I feel that, where we understand about you more rather than me speaking. So this is how online mode has to be. So Saraswati Mukherjee, developing scientific temperament among students in teaching chemistry. She has come up with her chemistry mode of teaching. So this is how where we feel that the interaction can take place. Okay, so that was any other question? So I will just move forward. Yes, Dr. Sevakumar?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yes, please.
Now, one of the things we missed in the online classes, I believe the feel about the learning process, the students, they may exhibit their, whether they understood it or not, they will express in their face. That we can observe it, and we can make fine correction in teaching, whether the pace of the teaching may be a little bit varied.
Yes.
And some of the relevant topics which are associated with this particular main concept can also be taught in the classroom. Whereas in an online classroom, I feel that talk about a particular subject, we just go through the complete subject without exploring the other branches of other things which are associated with it. It becomes a very, very focused one. And in fact, by way of online teaching, we could cover up more syllabus. But students, ultimately, I feel that they'll be learning a little bit lesser. Because within 1 hour time, when they're in the classroom, we can make sure that they're understanding the concept, whatever we are telling. Here, we cannot make it 100% assured. If we ask them whether he understood, they will invariably say, yes, I could follow it. When it comes to examination or maybe clarifying with some more questions, we will find that they couldn't understand the concept. So
you're very much right. So, yes, sir.
No, the presence, of course, with the presence of students only, better teaching learning process can happen. But of course, with the technology, we can try to improve. And of course, we can cover more in online teaching. But I feel offline is something better. But still, we have to find out some techniques to make it more participative by the students. I think other faculty members can give some ideas how to make it more participative by all the students.
Like here, as Dr. Sivakumar sir has already pointed out, it is very easy for offline, but challenging for online. It is challenging. So when there is no other go, we have to take this. And there was also a topic on problematic students. All the students are not, we cannot say that they are genius. There are some people who do not listen, who make others, you know, interactive. They just ask others some questions in the chat. They try to, you know, divert the attention. So one thing I would like to say is the topic or the chapter which you are talking about, if you can prepare a small quiz. So suppose you are teaching a small topic today. So tomorrow, if you have the same class, you can give the quiz of the topic, maybe 5 to 6 questions in a Google form or so, where you will be handling it so that it will be easy for you to know which student has undergone the, you know, the understanding, whatever you have explained in the class, or which student has not. So it is a challenge again for every one of us. So we have to accept it. Like we are accepting that we have to put mask when we are going to college. Okay, the ID card is there, but more than ID card is the mask now. And it is a challenge that the first corona, when it started, it is very much different when the second wave is going on. It's a challenge. We cannot just say that, you know, corona, you just go away from us. It's a challenge. And for that, people started taking vaccines. So this is a different type of, you know, different ways of our thought process where we are trying to see that we are safe. Okay. So can we come back to the PPT session again? Oh, sorry. So, yes, it was a very good discussion, and we'll put it for the end of the session so that I can go for the further things. So challenge is for everyone, a mother giving birth to a child able to crawl, then able to stand, able to walk and climb up the steps. But if you see this, the child is standing, but both the sides, mother as well as the father, they are extending their hands. When there is a challenge for everyone, you just remember that there are some hands extended towards us to help us out that we do not fall. So this is one of the greatest challenge which every one of us has faced, knowingly or unknowingly. Physically challenged. Are they not living their life? They are living their life with the way they take challenge by themselves. If they take challenge by themselves, they do supernatural, something beyond their limit. And people with hands and legs, those who are physically fit, they just go on staring about people that here's something they can do which I do not. They also take challenges. Mentally challenged, they do not know. They cannot be blamed for being mentally challenged. But anyhow, they have been taking challenges in their life. They're living a life, right? This is the place where I have been with my students. When you're talking about students, I make the students understand that you are far, far lucky to think that you are very much uprighted by God and the surrounding. Whereas there are people who have got so much of challenges to face in their life. You know, this is how with love and affection, we are making the mentally challenged people strong. Not only them, we are also seeing that the students who do not understand their lifestyle, try to understand by seeing them. There are also people who have been orphans. Is it there, you know, is it they who has to be blamed? They do not know why they are orphans, but they have been taken care by someone. So it's a challenge again. Even being in orphanages, there are people who have come up in their life, those who have achieved a lot in their life. You can see myself, I have taken some of my students in Orissa where I was there. It's just to show that how we can teach our students to face challenges in life. So when I took them to show that this is how students are, you are in a better field where you can do a lot for these people out. You know, still they are in touch with them. And if I share one of my experiences, When I was in an international organization in my first career of my lifetime, I have faced many challenges. No wonder I was going to change my career. So there were people of international students. They were very, very rich and they do not know what money is, the value for them. And once I just took them to a physically challenged home that was told to be as mercy home. So one of the students was very naughty, very, very difficult to control him. So I pointed that student also. So when we got down from the vehicle and we were going towards the mercy home, there was a person crawling towards us to welcome us. The student could not take it on. Ma'am, I cannot just see him. How much difficulty he is facing to stand. He's not able to stand. So this student, a rich buck, he did not know that there were some people who struggles in their life. This is a challenge which he took for the next day onwards, almost the same day on the same time, that I will be standing for this type of people. So the challenges will be faced by our present generation, but the challenges has to be shown by us. Then only they can come up in their life saying that, yes, I'm ready to face challenge. Now, how to support the emotional needs of our family? Sometimes I could see that most of my students, they have domestic violence at home. But why? Why do they have to face the domestic violence when there are problems with someone else? So in this case, I have pointed out what I felt to speak out. Listen to them. So when we are in our class hours, or when we are with our publication, when we are with our own educational needs for the students, somehow, somewhere, we do not, you know, accept the working atmosphere in the house. So we just try to get irritated with our own kids saying that, why don't you sit quietly and listen to me? So this is not the way how we talk to them. The most important thing that you can do is listen and actually hear them, what is being said. Listen to them, hear to them. There are students, those who say that, ma'am, when I get less marks, my parents say, why did you get less marks? They don't ask me, what are the problems that you have faced that made you to get less marks? See the question that can be asked in a different way. And you listen to them so that they can focus on yourself and create a good bond among you all. Ask questions. If they are not responding to you, you have the right to ask questions. If you are not getting a lot of information, but you are seeing a change in your kids or your children's lifestyle, you ask them, you ask your better half, you ask other members in the family. Try to involve yourself in the family in a different way. Family time is very important. Yes, there is always a disbalance in the work and family. But my dear all friends and dignitaries, I feel family time is very, very important. Create family time so that you can come together and discuss what is going on with the other family members. You just cannot say that the other family member is having temperature of what. You cannot just say that the other family members are taking medicines, I don't know why. Because the family time is very, very important. That creates a bond among all. But above all, don't forget yourself. You need to be listened as well. As I say that, others need to be listened, but don't forget that this is maybe a selfish character, but always be selfish to yourself. Don't forget about yourself. Try to listen to others. Make others to listen to you too. Okay? And yes, workplace, we find somewhere some relationship problems among the students also, among the faculty also. Now we have to figure out who are those people with whom you work, with who can really change your perspective of thinking, your perspective in life, and allow you to enjoy your work while working. So there are different types of friends, I think so. First is work companion or your buddy, those who are always there to talk to you. You know, you have someone to talk to whenever you feel down at work or need someone to listen. Obviously, we need other people to listen to us as we listen to others. There are career mentors also. There are, as faculty, you all have to publish papers, right? And this is a mandatory for everyone. So there are people who are into papers and they also feel that, come on, we will do it together. So that's another buddy of yours. Now, travel companion. There are people, okay, like we have been working for so long, let's go to the canteen. So there are people who will be pulling you to the canteen. There are different type of friends for you all. But besides all this friendship and all, there's a friend in you. A friend in you where you have to find out. Usually when anyone comes for any cases, two things I'll ask them without forgetting it. One is, do you love yourself? Another one is, do you live for yourself? If you really love yourself, how do you love yourself? So many come up saying that, my friends like me, my teachers really likes me. So it is not liking by others. It is liking by you yourself. Why do you like yourself? Why do you love yourself? How can you express that you love yourself? And if you are living for yourself, what are you have been doing that you live for yourself? Very, very important in our lifetime. And COVID time, no wonder. It's very important for everyone. Now I will just jot out some of the points which I felt how to face challenges in life. First and foremost thing is, accept the challenge. Until and not, unless you accept the challenge, you cannot face challenge. And when the challenge is given to you, you face the reality. So this is not a fantasy world which we are going through. This is a real world which we are going through. And in order to face it, in order to have it, you have to think positive. Like there is always a daytime, then comes the nighttime. So there's not always day, right? Or always night. So when there is a nighttime, you switch on the lights, switch on the fans, and there's a different thing which you have been doing just to take over the night and enjoy. So some people by evening, they go to gym, by evening they go for walk, they have a snacks time, they have a family time. It's different for different. Everyone is different. So take it positive and plan goals to achieve it. Yes, it is difficult for online mode teaching. But can't it be done? Yes, it can be done. So we have to think of different ways how it can be done. So never think of any negativity saying that I cannot do it. That's the end of it. Learn from the mistakes and obstacles. When you start doing something, there will be mistakes which you have not been thinking of it. So when you learn the mistakes and obstacles, then only you can go forward. Like when I was showing the slide of the babies, okay? So the baby cannot stand all of a sudden. Baby will fall down many times. It slowly, gradually grab something and stand. So that grabbing thing, we have to understand where to grab and what to do. So learn from the mistakes and obstacles. Look forward with high aspiration. I always tell my students, look for high aspiration. Then only you will be getting the high achievement. Just time management. Plan up something. I'm going to read this. And I'm going to finish this novel. I'm going to do this. Whether you finish it or not 100%, but you will be able to do it at least 70 to 80%, which is a good achievement for you. So if you achieve 50% also, it's a great achievement. Take each step carefully. with determination and dedication to face it. A small step is enough every day to go for it. This is how we face challenges. India is with a huge population, but still, vaccines have been given slowly, gradually to everyone. So we also started having vaccines here. But this is the first step. That is what I have been telling. Determination and dedication is very, very important. That will develop the positivity within you. Keep a control on your emotions. You know why I say that control on your emotions? Because somehow, somewhere, we may not be able to achieve it. So at that time, we have to control our emotions. We cannot just say negative or cry it off. We have to build up the confidence saying that, yes, I can. It's our perception. The way you perceive, you will see things as such. Perception is sensation with meaning. So the meaning is you who is going to give. No one else will give the meaning. Like as in this webinar, we can talk many more things, what we can do. But at last, you are the person to do it, no one else. Start writing a journal. It will help you. Like when you do something, if you write beside it, most of the things you are giving it off. You know, if I say something about the mental health, which is very important nowadays. If you take a glass of water, you know, drop by drop, the glass of water is seen falling on the glass. So there will be a time where the glass will be filled up with water. And when there's no space, obviously the water will just scroll down. So if I take our mind as a glass, and drops by drops of water as our thoughts. So please do not gather or accumulate the water, I mean the thoughts in your mind. If the thoughts are accumulated in your mind, it will just come out without your knowledge. It will affect the body as it starts rolling out in the body of the glass. So that's what I say. Start writing a journal. Journal in the sense you write your own thoughts out. If you spill out some water from the glass, you will see some space left out in the glass to accumulate some more water, isn't it? So when you write the journal and spill out some of your thoughts, whether you write it in a journal or talk to your friend whom you trust, so that shows that you are making some space in your mind to keep more and more thoughts. Practice gratitude. Some way or the other, we are thankful. Every day before going to sleep, if we think the whole day, some way we can think that I am thankful for this, whether it is 1 point or 2 points. It makes you think something positive. Gratitude is very, very important in a person's life. Celebrate your success at every step and seek out new ones. So maybe a success is 0.1% also, or 1%. Celebrate it because you have achieved it. Then only you can go further. Then only you can seek new ones. Never lose hope. Never give up. That is where everyone, big leaders, you know, transformers, the personalities, the dignitaries here, there, they all have been speaking about never give up. So that is what a challenge is. If you are taking a challenge in yourself, you will never give up. And yes, if you want, you can keep a role model in your life. Wherever you are sitting, wherever you are spending most of your time, you can keep your photo as your role model. No wonder. Everything will be done. When you see your photo every time when you wake up, that also becomes a role model for you yourself, because you're living for yourself, you're loving yourself. That's where you can do. So it was very nice to speak about challenges. These are my thoughts which I have given. Everyone has their own unique way of challenging their own life. As by Paulo, he has been very much remarked over here, everything will be okay in the end. If it isn't okay, it isn't the end. So you have to work on it if it is not the end. So COVID is not an end now. We are working on it. We have to go on working on it. Maybe we can take online as a challenge. Maybe we can take our family as a challenge, our kids as a challenge, and moreover, ourselves as a challenge. Are you ready to face challenge? Thank you. I am ready. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Before closing, I have a certain points, Dr. Rita.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Yeah. So I think in between somebody came, so I could not interrupt you. And the first point is that you said that how exactly the students are listening to your lecture or some question of quizzes which we can ask. I think the easy way to handle is that in the offline mode, we have a problematic students in the class, and sometimes it's being spent only in controlling them. I think whatever is word that which you can use for the controlling of the students, and that is not existing now here in the online mode. Only thing is that I would request all the faculty members whether they can take they can prepare the content for 1 year, either in the form of a PPT or in the form of some kind of a simple content where the students can read for a week's time, and we can give it, release it before the previous week. Supposing today is a Monday, this class which you are going to take it, we have to give it to them at least last week by Wednesday or Thursday for the entire class. So they can use the Google format and before start of the class, and then how many students have listened and they really read it, and some quizzes, then we will know how many are not doing it. Then based on that, your lecture can be moderated or it can be modified. Only those students where that you can teaching effectively, which you can do, which I believe this thing we can do. The second part is the celebration of success, which is the last part which you have been spoken about it. See, celebration about the teachers or the faculty is that we can recognize in the night or when you are going to the bed today how you handle the class. That is the success rate where that which you can do. I have taught well today. I have made the concepts to understand most of the students. And how exactly that we prepared and delivered, I feel that when I was taking class in a young person, this is what which normally I rate myself, how to be a successful teacher. The happiness comes only with that when today's my class was fantastic, I did well, and some mistakes which we might have committed, either knowing the concepts or not knowing the concepts and the things, those mistakes which that we can recollect and improve upon the next day when the faculty is start taking classes. I think it's the biggest challenge for us to run with the online, but no doubt it, but technology is enabling us. We have a lot many of videos which we can do, and therefore that it simplifies your work, and at the same time we should be able to explain to them in much more simpler way in the online. So thank you. This is my suggestion, please.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your suggestions. It's really helpful.
Another way of keeping the students very interesting online is once in a week there should be a complete online session on clarifying the students' doubts. Whatever that is being taught online, once in a week you should spare exclusively question and answer session exclusively for students. And in another way, to make them very interesting learning online, as soon as the classes get over, by the time you reach Friday, you can ask one of the students to give a presentation what has been taught to them online.
Good.
I think this is happening at the USA.
Okay. Yeah, we are adopting. But one final challenge I would like to request everyone. I don't know whether the challenge can be taken care of here or not. With the permission of the dignitaries present here of King's College and the coordinators, can we have a challenge of coming to the video and take a group photo to make it more memorable? Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm so happy. That's a great challenge. That's a great challenge.
Faculties are requested to
enable the camera.
Mute their videos. Unmute their videos.
So it's so nice. You know, I don't want to miss any of the great moments in my life. And this is a wonderful moment to be here with you all. I'm so happy. You know, so this is how the challenge is accepted, right? We can also tell in the online classes that, come on, come in the videos. I want to see you all. You people are so far from us.
Your session is actually an example of whatever you've been saying, ma'am. You have faced challenges. You faced technological challenges. You overcame them.
Yes.
You went on with the session. And you made a very great presentation.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, yes, it's really very enlightening. And your session was the main take home thing for me, right? And added to it are the bonuses that I got from people like Mr. Balachandran and Dr. Tyagaraj.
Okay, all are our great, great friends, and we will be in touch with everyone now. King's College also has come up to all of us here. So nice seeing you all.
King's College has brought us all together, right? We should be very thankful to them.
Gratitude. Yes.
You said gratitude,
right? Gratitude. Yes, yes, yes. Gratitude.
One last point I'd like to make, I think in order to get over the discomfort faced by the students, I think we should help the students to getting into ergonomically designed furniture. They need to be comfortable listening. They have to have a good air in the room, some kind of AC or cooler, so that they'll be comfortable listening to the online. Ergonomically designed furniture, I would definitely recommend. Most of the corporate leaders and heads of HR, they have given 50,000 allowance rupees to all the employees. My daughter told me she got 50,000 rupees allowance to go in for ergonomic design furniture to enable all the employees to work in a comfortable manner. Another thing, most of the heads of HR, they are figuring out and trying to figure out and cracking what should be the engagement strategy, virtual engagement strategy. Likewise, we need to reimagine our learning agenda. What should be the virtual engagement strategy for the college students?
We need to
brainstorm and come out with a creative solution.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Because as a counselor and as a leader of the organization, we keep talking about employee wellness, mental wellness, physical wellness, and social wellness. We have to keep in mind the health care of the students coming onto the online board. As you rightly said before you start the class, we need to interact with us. How did you find the morning today? How was your morning today? Did you eat fiber-rich breakfast? Did you listen to the mood-enhancing song? What were your mood-enhancing moments early in the morning? You need to interact with them in an interesting manner to keep the students very engaged online. This is my request to all the faculty members.
Taken.
Yeah. So adding to what Mr. Balachandra have told, I'd like to add, even in the offline mode class also, these things which we have to ask what Balachandra has said. But another suggestion for the management as well as for the faculty is that these online mode class, offline mode, the students can be asked to come to the college and keeping in view that the SOP, standard operating procedure for COVID. So some 30, 40 students can be asked to come to the college, and you give again the online mode of class by sitting in your room, and to see that you give a good air conditioned hall as Balachandra requested, and also have ergonomically designed chairs and this thing. You start taking classes from your own room. And then at the end of the class, we can go back to the same where the students are sitting, and ask them how exactly today's session was, and then kind of a feedback from the students can take it, and perhaps the faculty can take the feedback and correct their lectures at the next stage level.
And as a counselor, you know better. we need to continue to design a mindfulness program for all the students online. I think they need to get over the setbacks. They need to be known for the resilient power. So you need to continue to design once and for 10 days mindfulness program, bringing in a yoga therapist.
Okay. So it was a very good input by all, and we all are linked together. Wherever we are, I am in VIT Velo seated. So sir is in Chennai. So all the faculties from King's College. So it's a very much memorable thing. Usually we cannot do it in offline. So online has given us so much of, you know, a way or process to express ourselves. Yes, ma'am. It's a sense of gratitude to all of you, my dignitaries. Thank you.
I think Dr. Chagaraja has given a lot of vital inputs. I'm very happy about that. Excellent input you gave, sir, followed by Dr. Sundarabharathi. Oh,
thank you, sir. Thank you for your compliment. Let us keep get connected. Another problem in the online mode is that the connectivity, supposing the connectivity is not happening, we are not able to get the voices in the thing, sound is not, sometimes is not working. Yes. It's all, sometimes it's be irritating. So we have to see that before start the online mode, all these things are correct. I mean, fully corrected, experimented, and then go for the online mode. I think faculty have to doubly careful about putting on their pictures or the some kind of the videos or the equation which you are going to write it. All those things you have to be very, very, very careful before presenting on to the students.
I really look forward to the normal phase of functioning, and I hope everybody strictly adhere to the standard operating procedure, stay healthy, stay safe. Oh. And I look forward
to that. Can you all hear me? There's some problem?
Phase of life. Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. And I feel that I have come. Yeah, thank you, sir. Yes,
madam, please. Shall we conclude the session, ma'am?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Sure.
This is the time to present vote of thanks. First, I would like to thank our management and secretary, sir, for encouraging us to organize such programs. I would also like to thank our principal, madam, Dr. J. Arpuda Vijayaselvi, for giving permission to organizing this webinar session and giving guidance for us. Our wholehearted thanks to our resource person, Dr. Rita Bhattacharji, for enlightening us with their knowledge. Today's webinar was full of interaction and interesting things. It gave deep insights into the topic. I am sure that the precious knowledge that Dr. Rita Bhattacharji gave us will definitely help us in our process and future. Also, I convey my special thanks to Professor Balachandran sir, Sundarabharathi sir, Yagarajan sir, for their valuable inputs. Thank you so much, sir. I want to thank our vice principal, sir, and HODs of various departments for their continuous support. Also, thank you to all the faculties present here for paying your attention and cooperation. I would end my speech here. Also, I would like to thank Mr. M. Arun, APCSE, and Niranjan Samuel, R&D, for their continuous technical support. Thank you, one and all, on behalf of King's College of Engineering.